Ladies and gentlemen, talk about predictability. Our friend, the ladyboy lover, is going to have a scheduled show, Scam Alert. Is it an autobiography? More than likely. Now, because I was fortunate enough to make a couple of bucks on my last show, that really triggered him, like I knew it would. I told you folks, when anybody donates to my show, you're going to get Tricky Ricky triggered. And that's exactly what happened, and I'm sure it's triggering other people. Appropriate song for Licky Ricky, the loser. Now, on his upcoming scheduled video, he's more than likely talking about me. I'm not paranoid, it's just fact, I know. And he's very predictable what his show's going to be about. The holidays are coming, so Ricky figures that Frank is going to do a scam right away, because he's not making the kind of money that he wants to make, that Ricky is going broke. Henceforth, staying at the Decca Homes over in Tipoli in Mandawi with his shitty little apartment that ain't too much better than what Barry is living in. Yeah. Ain't that something? Anyway, I feel that there's a lot of jealousy among a lot of other YouTubers. Like I said, they want to see your relationship break up. They want to see you lose everything that's good in your life. But when they cannot achieve that goal, they go even more so, thumbs up folks, they go even more so on the attack. Very predictable people, I must say. Very, very predictable people. And I predicted that there would be a response to me getting donations on my show. That was a good test. If I made it to be a test, which it really wasn't, but if we were to say that it was a test, it would have proved positive. Nobody's frauding anybody but Ricky. Look what he did with Barry and anybody else, all went in his pocket. We don't have to go through that story again because every one of my regular viewers are quite familiar. Now, when you're with a woman like that, and I'm not going to say and define what I mean by a woman like that, I don't want to get illegal, but I'm going to say it again. When you are with women, the kind of women, this is a broad general statement, that generally, the kind of women that this man will have at his side are women that basically, you know, for the most part, you know what he has to do to get these women, okay? You fill in the blanks on that. As I said, I'm keeping it legal on here. And you make your own conclusions as to how you think this man is able to have a woman at his side. Is it because of his swarthy good looks? You answer that, okay? Is it his magnificent physique? You make your own conclusion on that. Is it because he's such a nice guy with a great personality? You make your own conclusions about that, okay? So very predictable. Now, of course, somebody's going to say something about me making Super Chat on my channel. Of course, as I said, they don't want me to make money on my channel. And when I do, and when my viewers give in and say, hey, here's something, Frank, you know, right away, you're going to call me an e-bagger. And right away, the green-eyed monster steps into play. And that's exactly what's going on right here. Look, I didn't make a fortune, but that's okay. A few people that did donate, and maybe one of them was a surprise, was all appreciated. But to try to do a show and say, and I'm sure the show's about me because it all matches up, that I made donations this past week and especially today, and, you know, that he's not making any money anymore because Barry's out of the picture pretty much, that, well, he's got to tone his lifestyle down a little bit. Don't forget, Fazio has a case coming up, and it might cost him quite a few pesos when you convert the dollar sign into pesos. He doesn't want that to happen. Oh, hell no, he doesn't want that to happen. Lotto Retirement says, not a good idea to talk about a man's woman, even if in code. I'm not naming any particular woman. I said women in general. Ah, you're not listening enough, Lotto. You're not listening. I managed my words quite efficiently. No names mentioned. Never said anything in particular, Mr. Lotto, about his current woman. I said in general. So I caught you on that one. Okay? Caught you on that one, Lotto. Not going to go there. Everybody makes their choices of who they want to be with. And sometimes they make their choices out of desperation or trying to prove that I got women in my life, I'm a real man, that kind of attitude that we hear all the time. A real man, real man, real man, and what real men are. Well, we know what real men are. Oh, okay. Glad I straightened you out on that. Thank you. I was almost ready to get rid of you. Almost. But I didn't. I'm glad that you can see eye to eye with me after my explanation, which I shouldn't have to explain anyway. But if you listen carefully to what I had to say, and I, in general, I don't pinpoint and, you know, and never actually, with this guy, ever pinpointed a name. He turns around and says that, oh, Frank's talking about my woman, saying that she's this and she's that. I never said his woman's name. What does he call her? Apple? Is that a real name or just kind of a nickname? I don't know what that is. A lot of Filipinos have some pretty weird names. I've never come out and said her family name, that she was a whore or anything like that. I've never said that. And if you listen to my shows, you'll know that to be true. I'm smarter than that. And I'm not pinpointing her and calling her a streetwalker, anything like that. We've been beyond this shit before. What's right to say, what's not right to say. We've been through, I think, a big show just a little while ago. And we addressed, in part, some of those type of issues. Never said his girlfriend's name. I was speaking, excuse the expression, broadly. Broadly, okay. Yeah, so Ricky, don't lose that number. Might be the last one you'll ever have. And the way this guy's going, it could be the last one. He's not a very healthy guy. But just as predictability comes along, of course, Ricky has a scheduled show. Fraud alert. Well, if anybody is really should be convicted for fraud, it's this guy. This guy. I'm not even mentioning a name. It's this guy who has fraudulently, I might say, taking people out of their money to go in his pocket, this man's pocket, to be able to afford these women that he accompanies, okay, and to buy cell phones for the women and his so-called five-star lifestyle, which is now going down to like a half a star, considering he's living in a dump in preparation for the lawsuit that Fazio has against him. And we're not lying about that. There is a lawsuit against him. He went to jail for 4 days. He slapped down an old man that could not defend himself. And that tells me right there what kind of a character he is. Nobody wants to see me making money on my show. Nobody. And when I do, they fall apart. They fall apart. Now, let's see. I think Popeye got some strikes. I don't possibly expect to hear from him anytime soon, although he will pop up and talk about this. And let's see who else is out there. Roberto, apparently he's been, you know, got more strikes than he wants. He's playing it careful. His videos were taken down. So who's winning? If you really need to use that word, winning, who's really winning on here? I'll leave that up to your thought. I'll leave it up to you. Okay.
So, scam alert, or as Ellie calls it, not fraud, but scam alert. Look who's talking. Look who's talking. Who took thousands of dollars out of the pockets of you viewers. No matter what the reason is that you donated to him, you still donated. And guess what? It still came out of your pocket. Not mine. It came out of your pocket for a fraudulent cause. I want to talk about scammer alert. Well, there you go. You people were scammed out of your money. We all were. And he was laughing behind the camera like he normally does. He was laughing at Barry, the very man that he was trying to raise money on the Free Barry Jordan Campaign to Freedom. And all this time, he was laughing at Barry. That's the kind of man he is. All this time, he was laughing at Barry. What kind of a man is this? What kind of devious dog-faced cockroach is this guy? As well as the guy he was trying to so-called defend, which we know already is a dog-faced cockroach. Coined the phrase from the famous John Doe. There you go. Scam alert? Hardly. I already said that donations on my show are in part, are indeed going to line my pocket. Unlike you, who say that you have a cause, but you don't really go through with giving all that money to the cause that you've been pushing for almost 4 months. I already said on my last show that there will be 25,000 pesos guaranteed on all donations that I make. Even if I fall short of making from your donations that amount of money, there still is going to be 25,000 pesos given to a Philippine this Christmas season. That hasn't changed from my last show this morning. Nothing's changed about that at all. I just want to make that clear. Scam alert, the only scammer, well, it's not only one scammer on here, we know many, but since we're talking about this guy, you're the only scammer. You're the one that defrauded people out of their money. Money, which is hard to come by these days. And when somebody comes forward and actually donates to somebody, all donations are significant because it's coming out of their pocket. That's $1 less, you know, $5 less, $20 less that they are going to have in their pocket, which they normally use to go buy themselves foods and pay their bills. That people being very generous with their money that they could have used on something else, but they decided to donate to you or me or anybody else. The sad part about all this is that unfortunately for a lot of these people, their money, hard-earned or not, were going to go in the hands of a devious criminal, a man who has done nothing but attack every fucking show on there that seemed to have a little bit of success, that was making more money than he was. Okay, I gotta read comments. JR, Real Deal, Maximus Pugliel. My God. If you have changed your name, I might not be in the list. Oh, it's still the same channel if I change my channel name. It's the same thing. Now, I have. Remember I said I was going to unleash the dogs? How about some thumbs up, folks? I have to remind you all the time. I have unleashed many dogs. A lot of people. I did that this morning, keeping my promise. Like I always do. Have I not? So this is directed to you, Ladyboy Lover. You have embarrassed yourself on YouTube for years. We all know you're a fool, but you make that fool out of yourself. Nobody has to help you out with that. Sorry that you're falling on hard times, but you've never been transparent. Where's the paperwork? Where's all the receipts showing that you have been giving people's hard-earned money to Barry's lawyer? You won't produce that. In fact, you change the topic all the time. When I've been on your show in the audience making comments, and you would refuse to answer that. In fact, you would put me on, well, you would hide me on the channel because you didn't want to deal with my questions. Now, Big Kevin is guilty about stuff like that, too. He does it all the time. Nobody wants to hear the truth about themselves, but let's tell you the truth. Let's talk about the truth. The truth is that the Ladyboy Lover, well, he goes both ways, obviously. Secondly, he's a thief. He's a criminal. He has threatened me and a lot of other people on here. And the last show that I heard from him, he came down very hard on my girlfriend. So you are most definitely on my shit list. And you know what I did with Barry as a result of interfering in one form or way with my girlfriend, her family. You are more than official on my shit list. You always have, but even more so. What are you talking about? Her pussy being wide as a river or some kind of shit like that, you said. Now, that was not cool. You always say, oh, no, I like Linda, the lovely Gilda, this and that. She's a good woman and blah, blah, blah. But what did you say on your last show at Brevis when you guys were both drunk off your fucking asses like the alcoholics, losers that you are? Oh, thanks for another 99 cents from John Blaze in the Philippines. Thank you. John did donate on my last show. So this is a double whammy coming from Mr. John Blaze in the Philippines. Okay, yeah. Lotto Retirement says, don't you think that Barry J would have said something if Ricky was taking his donuts? Barry is too stupid to know what's going on, okay? The only person that Barry thinks in his mind is supporting him is his girlfriend and the ladyboy love. Remember, this guy is not the sharpest tool in the box, but he'll sure take that corned beef brisket as an additional bonus to a meal free of charge that's being served to him in his cell, even from Ricky. It wasn't good enough. I want the brisket too. That's Barry's attitude. But it's also the ladyboy lover's attitude too. I want your money and I want your fucking firstborn's money. And I'm going to make all the promises in the world without transparency, to show that this money was actually going toward a lawyer or any other intended purposes in regards to his so-called charitable nature. He has never produced any documents really at all. Nah, he not really. At least nothing that I could recall. And if you know something he did, you can certainly tell me right now. Barry does not have a clue. But Barry, I think, is starting. It took him this long to figure it out because his brain cells, they don't work very quick. A little neuropathy going on there. To figure out that he's not getting the full meal deal. He's not getting the fries and the Coke with his burger. He's not getting the full meal deal. No, I'm not really defending Barry. Not in the sense that you think I am. I don't care what happens to that guy. I'm just saying that he did Barry wrong by saying that he was going to do this and that. And yet, how many shows did he see that he was laughing on the camera? Do you remember the one where he played the recording against Barry's wishes? Where Barry was asking him to go to Manila and try to do something for him? Then Ladyboy Lover comes on fucking camera and he's laughing in Barry's face playing the recording. Yeah, that's right, Barry. I'll go to Manila. I'll do that for you. I'll go there tomorrow. And he was laughing his ass off. This is the kind of person this guy is. He's the lowest on the list of the lowest scumbags in the world. And that's a pretty big list. It's a pretty big world, mind you. But at least on this community, we could concentrate on that. And he's among the lowest of the lowest. He's constantly attacking other shows. He's attacking other people, whether in the Philippines or in Thailand. He's made a lot of enemies on here. But because he shares the same cockiness, that Barry shares, he's putting the nails in his own coffin. I'm forewarning him, and I did. When you're that fucking arrogant, and when you're that fucking cocky, you don't see the error of your ways. And that's when you get in trouble. And that's how Barry got in trouble. And he swore up and down that nobody's going to deport me eventually. Nobody's going to put me in a jail cell. But again, where is he? Unless I'm living a delusional life. Last I checked, he was locked up almost 4 months. He's got 5 cases against the motherfucker, okay? So, am I lying? I never lied to you guys. Let me tell you something. And let me come straight out with something, too. I'm going to bury this all between these past 2 shows. All this shit that was going on in Hawaii, you know what? I could swear up and down that Jesus Christ came down himself was real. I'll say that in front of my girlfriend. I'll say that in memory of the love I have for my parents. Anything that's been good in my life, I've never did any of the things that my tenants ever said I did. Never. It was an effort, a vindictive effort to get away not only with the 4 months of rent, that's $6,000. 4 times 1, 5 is $6,000. I even paid their electric. Here's what you don't know. I'm just going to spin through this real quick, real quick. What you didn't know is that I paid their electricity. I paid their cable TV. And I paid their internet. That's what I did. By law, I had to pay the electricity. But by law, for this living situation, but by law, I did not have to pay their internet, okay? I did not. I did not have to pay for their cable TV, but I did. And when things broke down, I was Johnny on the spot to get things done. I'm going to tell you right now to bury this, because it is buried. And every single thing I said about what happened in that Hawaii situation happened the way I said it. All this crap about their kid. He's a good kid. I say this to today, even with the coercion of the parents. He is a good kid, and me and my brother like him, and I still like him. He was socially inept. He was kept behind doors, and he's underage, and him and his sister is still underage. They were left in that house when mom and dad wasn't home to take care of the grandmother who was in a wheelchair. They are not old enough. They were not old enough to do that. They were breaking the law. They were breaking the law. And when they destroyed it, did $8,000 worth of damage in several of my rooms throughout the house, they were breaking the law. They were breaking the law. Hey, Bill Smith, they were breaking the law, not me. Nobody ever touched anybody's child. And I don't want to be offending to them. All this shit about peeping in windows. Let me tell you something. I've said this before on my show. I'm going to say it again. And I don't mean to be offensive. There's nothing inside that rental when they were renting to me that I would need to look into those windows at. There was nothing, and I do mean nothing, that would take my interest of being a peeping Tom. Because to tell you the truth, like the police say on the road when there's an accident, okay, folks, go back home, nothing to see. Nothing to see. And believe me, there was nothing to see. That was going to drive me while I was painting the windows to be peering into their windows. And then the good one was I was sitting on a branch outside looking in their windows. There are no branches near the windows. The nearest branches on trees is about 35 feet away. 35 feet away. What was I sitting there with binoculars looking in their windows? Come on, get fucking real. They lied. Because it would benefit them. The biggest problem they made was that, well, they couldn't do this case against me before I sold the house. Because then, winning by default, they could have made some serious damage. They tried, and they failed. Now you might say, wait a minute, weren't we talking about $60,000? Well, they have to collect that. They have to collect that, but how? You can't squeeze fucking blood out of a turnip. You can't. Who won, really? See, these religious people, they have to live with themselves. I don't have to live with them. They had so many domestic disputes, you wouldn't believe what I used to hear behind my walls, that I actually had to put on, you know, those construction-type earmuffs to block out the sound? There were some nights I'd had to wear that because I really didn't want to hear what was going on. It wasn't my business, and I certainly needed to sleep, not to hear their arguing. And I really did not want to hear. I didn't want to hear. They had a daughter that wanted to commit suicide, and she had to have a psychiatrist. That's why they called psychiatrists for her. Had nothing to do with me. She had problems. And I heard it through the wall about wanting to kill herself. And I heard it from the tenants themselves when they told me and my brother that I was there, that they had an incident, that she was talking suicidal thoughts. Is he going to blame me for that? For what? Why? What do I have to do with her suicidal thoughts? I never even talked to the girl. I never photographed her outside purposely. I was videotaping my house. I just painted it. She walked out of her door. The only statement I ever made, it will end it at this. To my viewers, if you have the video, you'll know what I'm talking about. That I'm not lying. I said, that is my tenant's daughter. That she's only so-and-so age. And she's really tall for her age. That's all I ever said. But they turned that around and the viewers turned it around. That's what the story was. None of the events that were discussed by trolls on here were true. Even the documentation that says so-and-so tenants and children against Frank B. Well, because of the fact that they had introduced what they were hoping were going to be used in the case about the children, they had to use the entitlement of so-and-so in representing the children versus Frank B. They had to use that. But all that shit was thrown out. There were 13 allegations that were thrown out. Thrown out the door, including the so-called mushroom song that the judge did not see that as being illegal. No children were hurt, touched, accosted. Was it in a small room? Is it my brother's living room? Open sliding door, open to the world. He walked in. That was it. That was it. But no, the trolls had to embellish this. The tenants had to embellish this. Their psychological problems are there. I mean, the father has PTSD. What is that telling you? Did I cause his PTSD or did something in the service cause his PTSD? I did? And I got to pay for his psychiatric bills? I mean, really? The mother has Bell's palsy. Did I cause her Bell's palsy? Did I cause that? No, I didn't cause that. Yeah. I didn't cause any of that shit. It's their own pre-existing health and mental situations that they carried with themselves. But don't bring it on me. Don't tread on me. I'll wave that flag. This is don't tread on me. The only reason they won this case was honor to fall. That was it. Not by evidence presented. It was not, I repeat, by evidence presented because there was no evidence that would have worked without proof. Anybody could say anything they want in the courtroom and hope that the spaghetti that they're throwing on the wall sticks. That's the way it works. And because I didn't physically show up and appeared on Zoom, but I was there. I wasn't running away. He wouldn't allow it. So they went on default. Not because of, I'm going to repeat again, not because of evidence presented. I'm going to end the story on that because I'm making a point, and that's the only reason I'm doing this. No fraud ever going on with me. There's never been fraud. What I talk about on my shows are presented as factual, and the information comes from the other person's channel, audibly and visibly. Now, that's how we make determinations of somebody's saying something that's righteous or not. From what we hear and see, both in conjunction with each other, okay? I don't know. I don't care what Brevis does, to be honest with you. He can kill himself. I'm not going to shed a tear. They're all bums. They're all fucked up in the head in one way or the other. They're all fucking addicts in one way or the other. He's a pothead plus an alcoholic, you know. I feel sorry for the kid. That's all I could say. I won't say anything more than that. I just hope that his girlfriend has a healthy child. Let's do the right thing. Fuck him. You know, give good thoughts about the unborn child. That's the way you got to think down here. That's the way you got to think, okay? And it's the way we all should think down here. But Ricky has a planned show about scam alert, scam alert. The only scam alert is you, Ricky. How do you live with yourself? I really don't understand that. Wearing the same shirt for... But I got two shirts of the same. Well, how about a variety? How about taking a fucking shower? You talk about Fazio and his situation there? Really? How far from you from living that way yourself? You're living in a dump now. You can't even change your fucking clothes. You probably smell just as bad as the other guy. Who are you to make judgment on anybody? Who the fuck are you to make judgment on me or anybody? The guy who sticks his tongue down a lady boy's mouth. And that's all he does is suck down beer all day. Now, remember on the show we had with Brevis last night? When Brevis wanted to give him some hard liquor and he didn't take it? It's because he has such high blood pressure. And one time he admitted that he had about five drinks, his blood pressure just spiked. Just spiked like a mofo. He has some real health conditions. That's going to be the demise of him and other people on here. For sure. Ricky, don't lose that number. Yeah. You better kiss ass of any woman that you're with. That's what you're doing. You are afraid of being alone. And we understand that. We know a lot of people out there like that. They're afraid of being alone. So they'll do whatever it is they got to do to have a woman at their side. Now, I'm not going to say what they're doing to get that woman by their side. You could all decide for that on yourself. 140 calories every beer. He's obese. There's a lot of people obese on here. Now, I'm not saying that you're a bad person if you're obese. That goes to anybody on here. Obesity is a condition. I'm not saying anybody's bad. I'm just saying that, you know, you create your own obesity. That's it. That's what I'm saying. You know, he's got all that money. Why doesn't he buy a treadmill? But then again, Ladyboy Lover does a lot of walking. That's a plus. I'll give him kudos to that. He walks around a lot. But one of the reasons he walks around a lot, well, a couple of reasons. He really doesn't want to have to spend money on a taxi cab. That's one of the reasons. Hell, me and Gilda downtown, Cebu, we do our share fair walk. But we're not that cheap that we're not going to call a cab to go on our appointments or visit our mom or whatever we do. We're not that cheap. Ricky carried big stomach fat. Well, that's what kills you. When you got a big stomach like that, you also have what you call a fatty liver. That goes on and on and on. Cirrhosis, all that other shit that goes on. He walked to 7-Eleven to buy cheap beer. That he does. So scam alert, Ladyboy Lover, scam alert, you're the scam. Otherwise, we're going to give you an option. We'll give you an option. Fair enough. And fair enough to my viewers. We'll give you an option. Why don't you show us your little transparency? Why don't you show us everything you did, the several thousand or more dollars that you fraudulently collected for a fraudulent Free Barry campaign, okay? Where is it? Produce it. We want to see it. We're demanding that you give us a little transparency. If a man that wants to put on a show called Scam Alert, you're a scammer. You're disgusting, is what you are. And he's hating it that I'm making money on my super chats. Oh, I knew that would bring him out. I knew that he'd be doing a show about that. It's predictable. That's how predictable this man is. Predictable as what he does when he gets up out of his apartment over to Decker Homes in Tripoli, in Mandawi, to what he does in the morning, to what stores he goes to, okay? The local supermarkets, and then when he wants to, SNR, to get some of the same fattening foods that he gets all the time. We know his routine. Then he gets his girlfriend, and unfortunately, Barry did that with many of his girlfriends. To get them to be on his level, and to talk like him, and to give the middle finger to everybody. He's corrupting people, too, besides scamming people. He's corrupting his own girlfriends. Barry did that with his. Now, of course, you would have stayed with a guy if he's being very, generous with you, you know? See what I'm saying? Yeah. Not because he's a sporty, good-looking guy with a wonderful physique and a sterling personality. A charmer. It's not his sense of humor. With a big space between his teeth. If he had money, he would have corrected that a long time ago. If he smoked, he could stick a cigarette between that tooth. That'll be his cigarette holder. It could even be his microphone holder. If he had all this money, $8,000 a month, and his little criminal buddy there, Brevis, I've seen his paperwork. I've seen that he makes $8,000 a month. Well, we haven't. Of course, Brevis is going to kiss Ricky's ass. Because they're alike. They're both losers. They're both alcoholics. Couldn't trust either one of them as far as you could throw them. Of course they're going to stick up for each other. You have not proved to us, the people out there that have donated money to you, you have not proved to anybody that you're making $8,000 a month. It's just your word. Why don't you, and we'll believe you, even I'll believe you, show us the documentation and where it's coming from, the actual documentation, not docked up by you. You know, people have used, actually, my text that was not my text, saying that things I said to Nika, blah, blah, blah. It wasn't even her picture on there. Anybody can come up and put something together that looks like a messenger. But what we're asking you to do is to show us the actual documents. Well, a lot of documents that Barry actually has a lawyer that's defending him, even though my lawyer told me and spoke to BI that he is not represented. Another lie. Show us the paperwork that you are making $8,000 a month. Fred Flintstone? More of a Barney Rubble. No, he's more of a Barney Rubble than Fred Flintstone. Now, more Barney Rubble, I would say. Come on, how about some thumbs up, folks? It helps the channel a little bit. Not a lot, but it does help me get the thumbs up on this. Well, we had John Blaze gave, you know, 99 cents. Right on. It's okay. He donated on his last show. That's good. Cool. No problem. What we want here is transparency. So you want to do a scam alert show? Licky? Is it going to be an autobiography? Because that's what it would be, an autobiography. The only loser on here is you. You're a loser, and the people you hang with are fucking losers. You've lost all your life. You couldn't kick it in the States. You just couldn't. You became one of these fucking political radical assholes, shouting at the cameras, shouting at presidential candidates, for God's sakes. I imagine the Secret Service followed your ass around and did some research. You are a sick, tormented man, and a tormented man. You are in deep pain. You gotta have women around. You must have women around you to make you feel like a man. We don't even know if you could get the motherfucking thing up. Well, obviously we know that already because you displayed your bowl full of Viagra. That tells us everything right there. Am I lying about that? Nah, there's no shame about it. Produces a whole bowl of Viagra, which means his drinking and his health is not allowing him to naturally get it up. That he needs help from a chemical. There you go. No shame in that, Ricky. No shame. You can't do it, man. You can't do it. You know, you got to get a little help outside of nature, man. We understand that. But to admit to it and show us that you have to take a Viagra? Really? Wasn't it you that was knocking me, saying that I had ED? But wait a minute. Wait a minute. You produced a bowl of Viagra, which means that you have ED. Getting a little mixed up there, aren't you? You have ED. It's not a crime to have ED. If you have it, yeah. Prehistoric Archie Bunker, yeah. It's not a crime. We're not saying it's a crime that you have to take erectile dysfunction pills. Not a crime. There's some people who don't have erectile dysfunction problems that take them just to kind of ensure that batting season is up, if you know what I mean. They want to make a score with that bat. But we all know that you need it because you just can't get it up. As I said, don't fret. It's not a crime. It's not a crime that you have ED. It's not a crime. We're not saying that, and I'm not saying. Some men have to do that even when they get older. Even when they're younger, some men have to do that. They have some problems. It'll be physiological, psychological, biological, whatever it might be. Get the job done, they may have to take that blue pill. And maybe we should thank the manufacturers, Pfizer, for coming up with such a thing that if you really actually need something like that, it's available. And it works for some people. I guess it don't work for some either. But if it does work, inflation. If it does work, more power to you. You're not a charmer with the women. You never were. You're not exactly a good-looking man. And everything else doesn't fall together. You're insane. How embarrassing it was, I'm not even sure. I guess you were proud of showing those videos. You were proud of showing those videos of you yelling at Biden. You know what that told us? That you were out of your monkey-ass mind. That's what it told us. You were out of your monkey-ass mind. You come on a show, and you start pointing fingers at multitude of people's shows, jealous that they're making more money than you, got more subscribers than you. Boy, I don't know totally what happened to you growing up in your life. I don't know what your parents did to you, like whatever Barry's parents did to him. Maybe you guys are both in the same genre, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. And I'm not going to say that that happened because I really don't know. Something didn't go right in your life that made you flee out of the country. And I use the word flee to leave the United States. I think the law was after you. That's my opinion. That is my opinion. You didn't want to stay there. You didn't want to go back there unless you had to. Vegas to visit, things like that. Collecting vouchers that were thrown away. How desperate is that? So sure, we believe you make $8,000+ after taxes a month. Sure we do. You live in the dumpiest complexes in the city called Decca Homes in Tripoli, Mandawi. That's not five star, sir. That's not five star. And you're afraid of what's going to happen with Fozzie. That you're going to have to unleash your wallet and give the man money that you are so reluctant to want to do that it's killing you. It's killing you. Knowing what you did. You know that they're, well, you like to go to Vegas, right? You're a gambler, maybe? Nah, I think you just go there to pick up the vouchers. I don't think you gamble. I don't think you've ever been able to afford to gamble. But are you somewhat of a gambling man? Well, I'd bet. I would bet that Fazio wins this case. I would bet. Now you're saying, again, that Barry's going to be released this week. I'll go with that, too. What proof do you have of that? What proof do you have? There's no transparency with you. What proof do you have of that? None. What proof of lawyers that Barry has? None. What proof do you have that you have given all that donation money to Barry? None. Because you lined your greedy, sweaty pockets with people's money. So God forbid Frank makes super chats on his channel. Because you got to go do a show. Because you got to schedule a show.
called Scam Alert, because you don't want people to send money to me. Well, you're a little late on that. People have sent money to me. Okay. Scams with scam. I made a promise that during the Christmas season, I would put out 25 big ones in somebody's hand, and I most certainly will. You got a problem with that? Of somebody actually giving instead of taking? What I get, I give back to society one way or the other. One way or the other. I always give back. You know, 360 thing, you know, goes around, comes around type thing. I believe in it. Maybe you should. If you believed in it, you'll know that things are going to come around for you and not in a good way. Come on now, whether I like Fozzie or not, at the time, I mean, I'm very, like, you know, back and forth with this. I'm not saying that the yellow man didn't deserve to be slapped around like that. I'm not saying that. But if he was anybody else, okay, first of all, this was premeditated. Why would you pick on a man that's in his late 60s? This is a man that, you know, could not defend himself if he wanted to. No matter how cocky the yellow man is, he can kick everybody's ass and then some. We know he can't do that. We know he's a storyteller. We know he's not physically capable of doing that. But you yourself also knew that he was not physically capable of defending himself unless he had a weapon, and he didn't have a weapon. So you took the opportunity, premeditated, to rent a hotel right next to his rented property, plan it out, go out there, and as stupid as anybody could be, as stupid as Barry, while he is doing a live stream. Well, that shows your intelligence. You incriminated yourself right then and there, fool. And you had to go to court for that. You had to spend money on a lawyer. You had to put out a little bit of extra money, a fine that might have went to Michael, might have went to the state. I'm not sure. Had to spend 4 days in jail. How smart was that to get you there? Now you have to face the rest of his case. Well, hopefully, he cleans you out. It's not that I wish you well for the yellow man. I don't like him at all. I think he's another one that is mentally challenged. But still, you pay, as you like to say all the time. And you will pay. And you are paying right now. With all the enemies you made in several countries. You got to watch your ass every time you go to the bar. You know you're in no shape to fight anybody. When Mick Fisher came over, man, you nearly had a cardiac arrest. I was told, sort of, you know, under the table, that your face got pale. And a person concerned there said that he saw your face turning pale in front of Mick Fisher. And it looked like you were physically disturbed from that incident. That you nearly had a cardiac event. Yeah. Wow. And like, I'm not intimidated by you either. Because you will pay. You will pay. You will pay if you fuck with me. And guess what? You're paying right now. You just don't know it yet. You just don't understand who you're dealing with on here. Your good friend, which is not your friend Barry Lee Jordan, I think he fully understands now. But he didn't understand before he was incarcerated. That Frank ain't going to do nothing. He's all talk. Oh, that was the talk of the community. Frank is all talk. He's all talk. Apparently not. Are you going to be the next one, Ricky? Are you going to wind up in the same position as Barry? We'll see. How far do you want to go with this? Tell me. Write me. How far do you want to go with this? Look, I could be at your door any fucking time with an officer. I know exactly your apartment number, everything. I know exactly where you live. I'm not going to tell the public. They all know that you live, first of all, in the particular complex, but they don't know your apartment number. And I do. I do, but I'm not going to give it out. I'm not going to give it out. I can walk up to your fucking apartment door anytime I'm in Cebu. And what are you going to do to me? You going to beat up me and Gilda? Is that what you're going to do? Maybe we'll do that sometime. We'll see if you beat me and Gilda up. We'll see how far you go. I don't care if you strike me. I don't care if you strike me and knock me out. In some way, I'd welcome that. Because it would be on camera, definitely. Just like what happened with you and Fozzie. I guarantee somebody's camera's going to be on. Mine and or Gilda's. Strike me. I dare you to strike. Because, well, it'll just further my case against you. Pending. And I'll make some money on the deal. And I'll see you incarcerated just as Barry is incarcerated. I'm not your average person in many
out here have figured that out. My longevity on YouTube, everything else. I won't go through the whole speech again, but I'm still here, blah, blah, blah. I'm always ever been here. I'm not going to do that. But I am here. And you know I'm a worthy opponent. You absolutely know that. You have no question about that at all. Hey, man, you can strike me anytime you want. Anytime. Sneak up on me like you did to Fazio. Strike me. Do what you need to do. I mean, don't kill me, but, you know, strike me. Do it. Do it. If you want to see a whole new World War III, a lot worse than Barry's situation, yeah, you try that. You try that with me. And you see hell and fury like you've never seen it in your life before. And you will wish that you have never heard my name, that you have never done any shit against me on YouTube or talked foul about me on YouTube. I'll have you on your fucking knees, and you won't be sucking my cock, because I don't swing that way like you do. You'll be on your knees begging me for forgiveness. Frank, I can't take it in jail. I don't want to be in jail. I got women to abuse. I'm everybody's muse. I got to keep the entertainment going. Like, really, people give a fuck about you. Nobody gives a fuck about you, Licky. Nobody does. Nobody ever will. Okay, lot of retirement. Don't you think that Ricky, in his unique way, is trying the best to make the world a better place? Oh, he's doing that okay. A bit unorthodox for sure, but he's right. He's trying to make... You are an idiot, Lotto Retirement. So by scamming people, he's trying to make the world a better place. And by him trying to get people to free a criminal from jail just to do a repeat offense again, is contributing to the world?
Oh my God, Magnum.
Now, if I say, oh my God, Magnum, you're in... Oh my God, Magnum.
Are you that fucking sick? You're gone. You're gone. You are gone, my child. I'm not your psychiatrist, man, so I don't want to deal with you. All I can say is if you're on meds, keep them going. If you're not, they're not. I mean, if you're on them, they're not working. And if you need them, get them. You know what I'm saying? If you got them, smoke them, man. If you got them, smoke them. That's what I say. Damn. White Horse says you never see Ricky walk into the department store by clothing. Where you going? Oh, have you heard from our... Okay. Let's see something here. Address phone. Oh, okay. I just got a messenger here, folks. It reminded me of the big name, the Biggie's full name is, yeah, because I had lost his last name. Oh my God, everything from address, phone number, the company he works for. I tell you, I got people working for me. I'm not kidding. You wonder where I get all my information. I got people that work with me. White Horse says this, Ricky is making, you know, $8,000 a month, and then where is this? Well, whatever he makes, where is it going? Besides, you know, paying for the first companionship with women. Well, Ricky, don't lose that number. Don't lose those numbers of those women, because you're going to be a lonely man. Very lonely man. I'm not sure if it does, actually. I'm not sure if it does. I don't know. Who's listening to Skiller? Oh, okay. Passing comments made on posted videos. No exception. Let's see. Who is still listening to Steely Dan? After 46 years, it still sounds so beautiful and refreshing. Yeah, I agree. The song would still kick sand in the face of most songs in 2023. Well done, Steely Dan. Reading something on here. I think he probably would be too cheap to use the air conditioner, to be honest with you. He'd use a fan rather than an air conditioner. He's a sweat hog. He likes sweating. And boy, he's always sweating. He's got that rag around. But there's a reason why he's sweating. It's, of course, in conjunction of the tropical weather, of course. But it's 33 in here? Wow. it's not just the tropical weather, but he, when you have high blood pressure and you're overweight like that, you will sweat a lot more. And I really doubt that the guy really takes any kind of Gatorade type stuff to replenish certain elements he needs to replace the potassium and sodium and everything else that he's depleting from his body. Your point is, Buzz, it must smell bad. I would think so. I don't know. I've never been in there, but I would think that he's the type of person that's very unorganized, that normally his clothes would be thrown around, spoon everywhere, and that he will take to wearing a sweaty shirt, but he'd be too lazy to maybe wash some of his other shirts. Oh, I sometimes repeat things myself, like to make a point, but he does it, I think it's more on a cerebral level, more of a mental issue. Me, I say things sometimes repeated because I'm trying to enforce, that's the difference between me and him. I try to enforce what I'm saying. He does it because, I don't know, he's dyslexic, he's something, I don't know what he is. You know, well, he's trying to convince himself. And maybe he's talking to himself. Ken Unger says, Tricky has been wearing the same shirt for well over a week. That thing must reek by now. You are correct, Ken Unger. You are correct. It must smell like the Dickens right now. And he's got a girl with him. And if she can put up with that kind of shit, just like the women that have been around Barry, God bless him. That's all I can tell you. I think I draw the line. Hey, look, let's put it this way. If I was with some woman, and this woman was any woman, and she was hotter than shit. Hot, hot, hot. We're talking everything was put together right. No matter how good looking or anything, if she had poor hygiene, I would not want to be around. If she had bad breath, if her fucking pussy smelled, if she had underarm smells, and she didn't practice good hygiene, I could not continue that relationship. I don't care what they look like. Well, he can't say five-star lifestyle anymore because he's not leaving even a half-star lifestyle. I could not be with a woman that was uncleansed. There's no way in the world I could subject myself to that. Only relationship you could have with a woman like that is safe. Stay 25 feet away from me, get naked, let me jack off without touching you, without smelling you. Let me pretend that you're clean. Let me take a good look at your twat, baby. You know, that would be it. 20 feet away. Don't come near me. I don't want to smell you. If she happens to smoke and she doesn't use mouthwash like I do, I would tell her. I would tell her, don't be kissing me without using a mouthwash. And I smoke. It's coming from me saying that. That's right. And if I've been wearing a t-shirt all day and I've been smoking, you know that t-shirt's going to reek of tobacco. It's quoting what kind of say. If you're in a Marlboro, which I'm not, that's horrible, man. Oh, my God. Does that stick to your clothing? Ooh, God dang, brother. I change my t-shirts. And I don't smoke in the house. Sometimes you got to be respectable. Okay? If you're going to be with a woman, maybe the shirt is walking all his steps on its own. It developed its own. I gotcha. You doubt that Ricky gets on top of her. No, he'd probably kill her. Smother her. You know he's doing it dog style. You know he's doing that. It's the only way he could do it. But then his big belly would have to be way above her ass. There's a little mathematics that would be involved in that. Okay, now, wait a minute. Okay, let's push this up. Wait a minute, let me get my knees in a little bit closer. Okay, now stay still. Let me have control. I'll put my hands around your ass. Let me do the pumping. Wait a minute. Oh, I fell out. Another Viagra pill. I have to wait another 45 minutes, though. Shit, I should have just took the Cialis because that remains in my system. Oh, shit. You mind, honey, waiting another 45 minutes? This time, stay the fucking still. Keep your ass in that fucking position, bitch. That's what he... How do you know he doesn't talk to her like that? How do you know he doesn't talk to her that way? Yeah. Anyway, we're killing it today. We made a buck on this show. We made quite a few bucks on the other shows. We're killing it. We're killing it.
We're killing it, guys. We're killing it. Yeah, we're killing it. All right. People are coming through. My people are coming through. Homewrecker says that rumor is they found, I'm not going to say that because I don't know that his girlfriend found their profile and pics on a XXX website. That's speculation. That's hearsay. Come on, Homewrecker. That's not right. You know that's not right to say that. We don't know that. So don't say it. Because, you know, you have to prove something to be true. Yeah. I thought I was going to make it through without throwing up. Thanks, Frank. In pertaining to Ricky and his sexual techniques and whatnot. Well, hey, dude, when you're that big and sweaty, first of all, you'll be sliding off the woman anyway because you're so fucking sweaty. I know, I'm making myself sick. I was thinking about having a snack, but now I changed my mind. But there's a lot of... there's a lot of mathematics involved when you have a big guy like that with a small room. A lot of mathematics, you know, involved, how to do it. I mean, I didn't want to picture it in my mind, but I do know for a fact that these things happen when you're obese like that. And, you know, you got to find a way to make it work. Yeah. I don't know. I tell you what, I've heard stories about midgets with grown ass women. How do they do it? I don't know. Didn't you notice that all these really skinny guys, how many skinny guys, they want these really large women? Fucking woman, kill the guy. She ain't gonna get on top of some skinny little guy like Barry. She'd kill him. She'd kill the run. She'd smother the cockroach. How about a big guy on a woman? Same thing. She can get hurt. If he sneezed while he's trying to perform sex, and he sneezed at that moment, lost balance, he'd fall down on a woman and probably crush her. Damn. Well, we're killing it, man. We are killing it. So, let the ladyboy lover do their show tonight. Scam alert. That's his intended show. Scam alert. The only scammer on here is you in this community. The biggest scammer is you, sir. The biggest scammer is you, sir. You're the biggest scammer on here. Scammer alert. Yes, indeed. Indeed, scammer alert. Okay, guys, give me a few. You know how it is. I can't sit near the computer. Yeah, I'm having a laid-back day today. Today is payday for me. In other ways, making some big money today. Just kind of hanging around. So I thought I'd come on again. I seen that he was going to do a show. He was going to do a show called Scam Alert. Okay. I went right to it. I didn't waste any time to address it. I know he's jealous, Damon. I know that. He don't want anybody to take away the money that he feels that he should be deserving on his show. Maybe if he changed things around and became honest or something, maybe people really donate because they like to turn around to something, but unfortunately, people don't see it that way. He will never admit fault. I will always admit fault, and I did. When I'm guilty of something or a fault, God damn it, if I'm not guilty of something and you're telling me that I am, then you better win on default, motherfuckers. You better win on default, not by evidence. You better win on default that I didn't show up to protect myself, whether here on YouTube or in a real fucking court of law. You better hope that I'm not there. You better hope that I'm not there. Yeah. They're all jealous of everybody. That's because not many people have a fucking life. They got to get involved in everybody else's life on YouTube. That is their life. Like our parents used to sit around. Mine did. My mother sat around for years watching her favorites. General Hospital was her favorite. Okay. I remember some of the characters in there because I was a kid. And I used to sit around. I was a homeboy. A mommy's boy. I certainly was. A mommy's boy. Mummy's boy. I certainly was. I used to watch these shows. Monica. And all, you know, all the characters on it. Luke and Laura. You know that Popeye lived by this stuff, Popeye. He could tell you every fucking episode of Days of Our Lives in General Hospital, but mostly General Hospital. And that's as an adult. I didn't watch that shit as an adult. He's an adult, and until General Hospital ended, and I think they did,
The motherfucker is still watching that show. You think his life is not a fucking soap opera already? That he needs to watch a soap opera? Never creating soap operas on fucking YouTube with his stupid little skits and stupid eating the corn, eating the, you know, corn out of his shit, and that stupid little jingle he does about San Miguel beer that people are sick and tired of hearing. Get original, bro. Get fucking original. And by the way, I saw Nico's, one of his shows. He was at Clearwater, Florida. That was a very nice beach scene, by the way, Nico. I have been to Florida. I've not seen all the beaches. I've been in Miami Beach area in Key Biscayne and near the Everglades. I've been there. I even took a boat. That was funny as hell. I was like Don on the, what do you call it? Don Johnson. I was laughing. I had a kind of a girlfriend in Florida who lived in Key Biscayne. I went there to visit her. And we actually rented a boat on the channel. And that was around that time. You know, the Miami Vice song. And they wouldn't let you take the boat. The thing was, they only wanted you, which was a ripoff, they only wanted you to use that in that immediate channel. They didn't want you going to open water with it. So, you know, we had to abide by that. But I gunned that fucker up. I gunned that puppy fuck. I did. Wind blowing in my hair. Wind blowing in my girlfriend's hair. It was fun. And I joked around her about the Don Johnson thing, you know. By the way, my thumbnail, let me tell you what that is. That was at Teaser Festival in Labangon. And they have the Show My Festival is what it was. Show My Tisvisa. Okay, how does it go? Show my Teaser. I love that song. It always reminds me of my early days in Cebu when I was visiting. I mean, they played that song during that festival. And Teaser has this festival every single year. I forgot when they have it. Because they're known historically to have pretty much, you know, made the, what we know as Shomai. And a lot of the Shomai comes from Teaser. That's where they make it. Now, there's different ways to make it. You can make it with pork and shrimp, ground pork and shrimp. It's very good if it's done right. And I attended that. I remember I spent part of a very hot day. That was when I was kind of hanging out with Joy, you know, the one that records me. Yeah. And every 5 minutes, show my to teaser. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You remember that song? I'd be singing that for a long time. In fact, you know, when you go into Prince stores, they have this, and it's the same people who sung that song, the teaser song, the Show My song, the Show My to Teaser. Same people. And you go into Prince, you'll hear on a loudspeaker some advertisement or something, and they're singing Prince, what is it called? Prince Superstore, no, whatever they call themselves. And I'd be like, you know, that's the same fucking people, man. I know their voices. Every time I go in there and I start repeating it, I start singing it. Anyway, guys, listen, I think I spent an enormous amount of time on here today. Thank you for that last donation. Appreciate it. And I had a goal. I had a goal on last show. I said I was going to try to raise $200. We raised $100, okay, and I didn't stay on there long enough to promote it. So I kind of cut the show short, but we were on there for quite a while. We were on there quite a while. I didn't reach the goal that I wanted to reach, but it's okay because, you know, we did very well. We actually had some colors on the screen, which is nice. I mean, it's nice to see colors on your screen, the colors of the rainbow. And last show, we had a few colors on there. That was awfully nice. We have one color on here on this show. Okay. It's nice to see the colors. And blue from John Blaze. I love blue. 99 cents from John Blaze. He didn't have to give me anything anymore. He already did. He didn't have to give me shit. He don't have to give me shit, but he did. And nobody coerced him or forced him to do that or anybody else. Okay. So tell you what, guys. I think I'll probably end it right here, okay, because I need to do a few other things. I haven't even eaten lunch yet. Speaking of lunch, I might skip that. That's my way of fasting, not starving my body. By the way, was Fazio on today, or did he drop dead from his so-called fasting? That'll do us a favor. Oh, please do. What an idiot. That's not the way you do it. I already did a show on that. I'm not going to be repetitive on that. It's just not the way to do it. And he's not going to accomplish what he wants to accomplish by doing it the way he thinks he is. Mr. Knowledge, Mr. Know-it-all, don't know shit. You don't know diddly about Mrs. Piddly. You don't know shit. With that being said, thank you, folks. Again, I am here only because you're there. If you are new to my channel, we've made 70 new subscribers this month now. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Please hit the notification button. You know when I do my next show. And join the fun on my show. Join the valuable information and insight and philosophy that'll astound you. We talk about science, philosophy. We talk about it all. We're out of the box here. This is a show where we speak out of the box. We come out of the box. That's what we need in this community. Out of the box. And out with the fucking lies. Nobody's scamming better than you, Ricky. Nobody's scamming anybody for the holidays. I'll beat you to the punch. Nobody is scamming. I already said that the money I have on my show, of course it's going in my pocket. Where else is it going to go? But I said that there will be 25,000 pesos of money earned. Even if it isn't earned on here, on YouTube, that there'll be a guarantee of 25,000 pesos going into the hands of a Filipino or Filipina. That goes. So where's the fraud? You're a losing prospect, Ricky. In fact, you've lost already to a lot of people. I wouldn't want to be you for all the money in the world. Not for what you look like. Not for what makes up your psychological makeup, your ways, your demeanor, your lack of hygiene, your cockiness, and your scam. I would never want to be in your shoes, ever, for any kind of money, because I could not live with myself. That being said, take care, folks. Catch you on the next show.